we got to the point where we can create our first automation. In this example, I will simply create an automation that is going to connect to my Outlook account and download a report, or download a sales report. It's very simple, very straightforward, but you will get an idea of what I'm saying and how easy it is to create automations. So first of all, I will open up my UiPath automation, UiPath Studio, actually. I will create a new process. I will call download sales report. And I will put here, download. You can put whatever you want, just a description. And it's going to take a few seconds to load. Okay, so now UiPath is ready to go. I will open up my main workflow. I will show you the email that I want to download. It is this one here, sales report. So I will right away create an activity here, Outlook, get Outlook mail messages. And then I have a few properties that I have to change here. This is the account at gmail.com. This is the folder. Number, I will read only one. So that's it. Mark as read. And then from here, I can create a loop for each. And the type of message will be, let me get here, mail. Okay, so the type of message is mail message, type of variable actually, from the system.web. And I will select here. Now my for each will understand what I want. Okay, so let me just go back here. I will create a variable. And here is my mail list. And then here, I will use my mail list. And then for each one, I will use this other activity, save attachments. I will define what is my the quotes. I can also define the path. Let me get a path here. All right, so I created this download folder. I will use it here. It can be anywhere, it can be whatever you want, just for the sake of this example, I will use this one. And then I am ready to go. See, very easy, very straightforward. And let's give it a run. I will open my Outlook here. It's going to mark as unread in a moment. Let's see. That's it. Let's jump to my folder and the file is here. Okay, we have a few messages here. Let's see, just the time. Yeah, so 5 seconds to run. Yeah, that's not too bad. I mean, I could do many different things different here, but it always depends on your scenario and how much time you want to spend on each automation. All right, so that's about it. Thank you so much and see you soon.